Magnificent Sound. Beautiful, beautiful Saturday morning as fall has finally arrived, it looks like. A little later this year than normal. Been a very warm fall, but not so much this morning. Around 33, 34, 32 in some places. So nice, cool morning. Some ice on the windshields last night, I'm sure. So, but glad to have you with us. It's another Saturday morning. David Kieberl on with Terry Reinhart. Evan Lubbock on the board this morning. And I think Jason's coming in a little bit. Smoke, didn't Jason say he was coming or not?
I think he's going to come in, yeah.
If he's awake. Like the rest of us. Understandable. I tell you, it was a late night for me last night getting in back into the Lincoln area around 1 o'clock. A little bit after 1, all making the trip back from Reidsville and doing my best to stay awake. Rick and Brett preferred that I stay awake
since you were driving.
Since I was driving.
Yeah, and that'd be a good thing.
It wasn't too bad. It wasn't too bad. Not a bad drive to Reidsville either. I thought that might be, you know, a little dicey with the traffic, 5 o'clock traffic by the time we hit Greensboro and that kind of thing, but not too bad. Traffic moved right along. I wouldn't want to have been coming this direction because traffic on the other side of the interstate, they were sitting still for a while. So
I'll tell you one thing, David, about that game that y'all went to. I was amazed when I looked at the records of all the other teams that was in that conference. That might have hurt Reidsville.
Yeah.
I mean, when you're playing teams that everybody in that conference was below 500.
And they were a little down this year as well.
Yeah, they were.
Themselves, you know, didn't
offensively
they were good.
Yeah.
Offense they struggled. Yeah. And then when we got there, we talked to the guys in the press box, which one of my favorite places to go. The guys are real nice. And Alan Ford had already told me, look out for the barbecue there. It's dynamic, and it was. A couple years ago when it was chili, the athletic director made a big pot of chili, and it was good. And I told him I was looking forward to that chili, and he disappointed me for a second, saying, I didn't make it this year. I made it last week. He said, but I did get sugar shorts barbecue. So, and it was good. It was really good. But those guys were telling me they weren't as good. They weren't up to par on offense. But here's the bright side for them, eight seniors. Only eight seniors on that team. So, including the quarterback coming back. And they're, you know, they're already pretty solid on their lines, defensive line, offensive line, pretty good. So, you know, they'll be much better next year. And you would expect. I don't know if you saw my tweet before the game, but I put a tweet out there that said, at Reidsville tonight, where they boast one flag for each of their 18 state championships.
Sure is.
And those flags are flying high behind that home stand. You know, that's pretty incredible and pretty intimidating if you walk in there and see all those state championship flags. I guess more state championships than anybody.
Yeah, they have.
State in North
18.
Carolina. So that is impressive. But wasn't their year. Wasn't their year. And here's one thing I've noticed, and this is no crack on Reidsville at all, but have you noticed that usually if they are a large team, they go east. And if they're a small team, they wind up in the west because there's a lot more 2A small schools in the west. So they're always on that border. You know how teams wondering if they're going large or small. They even wonder if they're going large, small, east or west, because they're right in the middle of the line. I don't think they've ever come out of the west bracket to win a state title or to get there even to make it. It seems like that always coming out of the east. You know, we see them playing Shelby in the past. We've seen them play East Lincoln in the past. Seen them play Newton Conover.
Bandies.
Yeah, Bandies twice. Yeah. So we've always seen them come out of the east bracket. And don't think they've ever made it out of the West. So what does that say about the West side of North Carolina? A little bit stronger, you know? Seems to be a little bit stronger if it's harder to make it for Reidsville. But I can't confirm that. That's not a fact for sure, but I don't think they have. You know, just by looking at some of the times they've got there and who they've played, I don't think they've ever come out of the West. So says a lot about the West, don't it? Says a lot about the West, how strong it is. Big night in high school football. We went from 128 last Friday night down to 64 games. And I tell you, it was kind of a night for upsets. And we're going to get into all the scores for a minute. But I guess the one that surprised me the most was in the eastern part of the state with Havelock.
Yeah, in Scotland County.
Scotland County. I mean,
both Wake teams have Forest.
Been Wake Forest. Both those, all three of those teams made the championship last year, right? And Havelock been a regular late, and so had Scotland County. But they went down last night. And I'm going to tell you something. The guys in Reidsville were keeping up with the Havelock game very close because Moorhead is in Eden, North Carolina, and that's the team that traveled to Havelock and knocked them off. That's the bordering school right above Reidsville. So those guys were keeping up. And let me tell you the main reason they were keeping up. 18-year head coach at Reidsville, retired, went and coached Moorhead and won that game last night. So basically like a buddy of theirs. And, he went to Moorhead and got the job done for Reedsville. So, I mean, for Moorhead over Havelock.
You know, speaking of that, three of the undefeated, there's 14 coming into last night, and four of them fail. Three of them come from the East. We just mentioned their names. And
so West, all three of those were undefeated.
Yeah, and West Montgomery out of the West went down.
That was a surprise, too.
And I was surprised at the score because Walkerdown put up 63.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, Brett saw, and you may know the answer to this, Brett saw on Twitter on the way home that I think West Montgomery was up 21-7.
They were.
Up 21-7 in this game.
They were up.
and then a 42-point second half for Walkertown last night against the 1AA's number two seed and undefeated West Montgomery. So, that one surprised me as well. So,
That just shows how maybe Pine Lake Prep was a little bit better than what we thought because they beat them in the first round.
Right. Pine Lake Prep just got the unfortunate draw there because, you know, they were 10-0 on the season and lost their last two.
Sure did.
They lost to Community School of Davidson, which dropped them out of a one seed, put them all the way down at number seven. And that seven didn't work out for them too good because they played Walkertown the 10 and lost in the first round. But, yeah, as much as we talk about in negative ways a lot, Terry, about the private and the charter schools playing in public, Community School of Davidson and Thomas Jefferson both playing a conference here locally and both doing well.
That's what I was getting ready to say. Out of our own Southern Piedmont 1A, and, you know, for us as a group and our conferences that we cover, I mean, I'm proud of that. I mean, you know.
Yep.
But I don't like the scenario of what's happening in that conference of how they flip-flopped with Cherryville and Bessemer City going to the bottom. But as far as on
the
other
end.
Yeah. But as far as the other ones, you know, I mean, they're respecting the Southern Piedmont 1A very well right now.
Well, before we go any further, Jason's rolled in and the guys have the scores in front of them. We'll just go through all of them from last night. Big night in high school football. I tell you what. We didn't see near as many blowouts last night as we did in round one, which is usually the case. And last night was a lot more competitive. And we even saw some upsets, some games that were true upsets, you know, not just in the seeding numbers, but actual upsets. What you got?
All right, in the 1A West, it's Murphy pulling off the 28-27 victory over Rosman. It's Robbinsville defeating Winston-Salem Prep 37-15. Thomas Jefferson shutting out Union Academy 24-0. Community School of Davidson shutting out Andrews 24-0. In the 1AA, it's East Surrey defeating East Montgomery 56-35, and Walkertown defeating West Montgomery. That's an upset. Number 10 defeated number 2 West Montgomery 12-0, 63-35.
In the 1AA, it was Mitchell 41, Mount Airy 14. It was East Wilkes 22, Swain County 7. In the 2A, it was Lincoln and 36, Reedsville 6, and it was Mount Heritage 30, Thomasville 22. And also in the 2A, it was Mount Pleasant 52, Hendersonville 46, and Shelby over Winston-Salem Carver 34-9.
In the 2AA, it is East Burke with the upset win over West Stokes 27-21. East Lincoln defeats Wilkes Central to move to 13-0 in the season, 47-6, and overcoming an injury to Chaz Surratt in the first quarter. It's Franklin defeating West Caldwell 31-7. It's Monroe continuing their undefeated streak as they defeated Maiden 58-20, and this is 2AA playoffs. It's in the 3A, it's West Rowan defeating West Henderson 41-19, and Statesville falls to South Point 42-21.
Continuing in the 3A, it was High Brighton 28, St. Stephen's 23, Kings Mountain 21, Freedom 6. Big win there for Kings Mountain, setting up next week with High Brighton. In the 3AA, Weddington goes up to AC Reynolds and defeats them 28-21. Next up for Weddington will be a visit over to Crest, a 31-21 win over Cupperson. In the 3AA also, it was South Iredale 14, J.M. Robeson 13, and it was Concord 37, Ledford 0.
In the 4A, it is 71st High School traveling this week to Charlotte as they fall to Charlotte Catholic 20-13. Upset number 7 seed North Davidson knocks off undefeated Scotland County 46-42. Also in the 4A is South Caldwell with the upset win. I would say upset considering although South Caldwell had a higher seed. A.L. Brown did have a home game. No, South Caldwell had a home game, 23-14. It's Greensboro Dudley, number one seed, continuing with their winning streak as they defeated Southwest Guilford 42-0. At Mallet Creek and Butler, their third game of the season, and second game of the season, excuse me, and it's Mallet Creek with the 35-30 win, and it's Huff defeating Audrey Kale 34-7 in the 4AA playoffs.
Also continuing in the 4A, it was West Forsyth 20, Myers Park 3, and East Forsyth destroys Independence 49-7.
I was telling these guys, Jason, before you came in last night, we stopped on the way back in Clemens to get refreshed, wake up a little bit, you know, get something to drink, whatever, and use the facilities. And I was in this store, convenience store, right off of I-40 in Clemens. We run into a coach from West Forsyth and started talking to him. And, you know, they play East Forsyth this week, undefeated East Forsyth. They lost to him earlier in the year, 28-24, close game. And then he asked me, he said, where are you guys from? And I told him, he said, my dad went to Langton. So how about that?
Small world.
Yep, a Yoder. I think he said Larry Yoder. So unbelievable that we ran into him. And then we just started talking a little bit. And I said, hey, I got to get home here. Got to go. Going to be a long night by any means. A short night for me. Quick turnaround. But enjoyed it. Wouldn't have it any other way. I enjoy high school football so much, and coming in reporting on it on Saturday morning, that, you know what, if I didn't get any sleep, I'd be all right. I just come straight in and come over here, I'd be all right. Hey, you know what, if I made one of those Mount Airy to Whitewell trips, I'd probably have to do that.
Yeah. Fayetteville to Asheville.
Just go straight on back to the radio station and stay there. You guys, you know, some of these games, I want to start with a couple Eastern scores last night, because Havelock fail.
Yeah.
We mentioned that. Scotland County fail. And the third one was Wake Forest. Wake Forest.
Wow.
Sure did.
Offensive lineman. Yeah.
In the we talked about Scotland County just for a minute last week, and it was because first round last week played Davie County, and they gave up either 34 or 36 in that opening round game last week. I can't remember which it was. They won, obviously, to get to the second round. But I thought then, man, if you're giving up that kind of points in the first round, your defense isn't what it normally is, and just not exactly sure how far you can advance. Well, last night they did it again, Terry. Gave up a lot of points again. What was it in the first round? 34, 36? And then last night, 46. So over 80 points. 80 points or more, I'll put it that way.
In two playoff games.
And that that's got to sting a little bit. I mean, that's, you know, but you know what? I mean, don't get greedy if you're Scotland County, because you have definitely, you know, or if you're any team, I'm not just pointing this to Scotland County, there are going to be seasons that you don't have quite the success that you've had in the past. And you know, unfortunately for Scotland, last night their season came to an end. So,
well, you know, they played at Davie County, like you said. And, I mean, 44-36 was the final in that game. And I'm the same way.
So it was 36.
Yeah. Mm. And then you give up 46 next week. I mean, I don't care, and this is just my opinion. I know some people look at it different ways. I don't care who you are. When you get to the playoffs, you better have some type of defense.
Because
eventually somebody's going to figure out how to stop your offense. And, you know, we have seen this, and I'm still go back to when Lincoln was so good and they went to the championship, I think it was 2005, and had to play Clinton.
Yeah, 2005.
You know, and Clinton was able to match up with every speed guy they had. And, you know, and what a difference that made in the game, because you was not just scoring at will the field.
Yeah, and that championship game was a 13-6 game.
Yeah.
Not low scoring. If you look at defense, look at the three games that was that we covered last night. Shelby gives up 9 points. Lincoln gives up 6 points. East Lincoln gives up 6 points. So you got three teams right there giving up less than 10 points in the ballgame.
Yeah.
Yep. And a lot of these teams are known for their offense. All three of those teams pretty much are known for how good they are offensively. Mm-hmm. But they're also three of the best defensive teams in the area as well. And that's what's.
We mentioned yesterday on the pregame, we come in, and I know Shelby's defense, it always gets better as the year goes on. And they was averaging over 20 points given up. But now every Cleveland County team that's still in it, I know Chris was giving up like 12. Kings Mountain's only giving up like 15. And now Shelby's down to 18. And when you have that out there on the field, you giving your offense an opportunity to win the game if your defense is going to play up to par.
Same thing with East Lincoln. The last 2 years, it seemed like as the season goes along, their defense gets better and better. If you remember the state championship, it was a defensive play, defensive end, Tristan Dennis. No, Tristan Dennis with the block extra point there, you know. So
yeah, by the end last year, East Lincoln's defense was every bit as good as their offense. It really was. And still was kind of unheralded because Surratt makes so many plays on offense that he kind of stands out more than that defense does. You know, it's like if you go out there and you play good defense and you hold any team in the playoffs, to me, if you hold anybody to 14 or under in the playoffs, you've done a tremendous job. But it's kind of like, hey, that's what we expect out of you, so it don't get, you know, the attention as the offense. Same old thing. Offense sells tickets, and defense wins championships.
And speaking of two more, Thomas Jefferson shuts out somebody. Community mm-hmm. School of Davidson shuts out somebody. So.
And in Kings Mountain last night, only giving up 6 points to Freedom. Who
to Freedom.
Who would have thought about that? You know?
And how about those Mountaineers? A nice win for them. Jason, Thursday night, I told you that was my upset special, and I didn't have the guts to pick them on our website.
Me either. I started to type Kings Mountain, and I didn't on the website there.
Well, there was a couple that I did take. I did take Kings Mountain, and also I did take East Burke. Yep. And the only reason
that's the one I meant was East
the
Burke.
The one that I took East Burke is on account of Tom Brown. I know he's one of the best motivators that you could ever have. I would have loved to been in that locker room at whatever speech he gave. That even that team knew it was big for him. Number 500.
Yeah,
let's don't go out here and lose number 500 for our coach.
And they didn't. They didn't. They pull off an upset up at West Stokes last night to move on to the third round. Problem for East Burke is they're going to have to go through number three, number two, and number one in that order if they happen to make it all the way to NC State to play in the title game. And that will be tough because we know it gets a little tougher each and every week. East Lincoln this week will host East Burke. So I'd like to see. Here's the funny thing, though. Like, wouldn't you like to go back and look at Tom Brown's record against East Lincoln all time? It's pretty good. It's pretty stout, but this is kind of like a new era East Lincoln here that we're dealing with, and they are really good, really good offensively.
Well,
and for you, let me go ahead and report this for folks that are wondering out there. Everybody heard last night Chaz Surratt dislocated the elbow on his throwing arm. Was supposed to have an MRI today, but the good news is he went to the doctor last night. Ryan Herman reported late last night he went to the doctor last night. He did get the elbow put back in place. There's no pain from what I heard, no pain, a little soreness, but cleared to play already next Friday night.
X-rays were negative last night. He's going to have an MRI Monday just to check for make sure there's no ligament damage as a precautionary measure. But doctor has cleared him.
Already cleared him to play, which is impressive. And if you are East Burke and Tom Brown, you just shake your head.
Okay.
Can't catch a break. Can't catch a break and keep this kid out. And you know what? He's one of those kids that the arms are going to have to fall off before you can keep him out of a football game.
Well, he was, like I said, he was trying to prepare himself to go back in last night. And he put place back in his elbow, and it came back out. And so once it came out again.
Well, and got to give credit where credit's due to Marcus Graham, who filled in nicely. He was a little shaky to start things off, but the freshman quarterback, when he came in, did very well for the Mustangs.
Impressive that they've got that kind of people waiting in the wings to come in and do a good job. We're going to take a timeout. We'll come back with more sports talk right after this.
The money you save in your savings accounts earns interest, so it just makes sense to have your checking account also earn interest for you. A money market checking account pays interest and also offers the flexibility of writing checks. Certain fees may apply. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded just like you.
Philly Brown, reverse motion. Cam Newton looks at him. Instead comes the other way screen. Fousey Whitaker, 30, 25, 20, accelerates. 15 to the 10, pylon left side, touchdown. Carolina Panthers.
Fousey Whitaker.
Carolina Panther in NFL football right here at Big O Country, WHS, WCSL, and WLON.
Hi, everybody. I'm Randy Owen, inviting you to join me this week for Country Gold, where you'll always hear the greatest hits of all time, plus songs and stories from my guests.
Hi, we're Exile.
We'll join Randy this week to play our favorite classic country hits.
Join me, Randy Owen, this week on Country Go.
Country Go with Randy Owen, Thursday afternoons 1 to 5, right here at Big O Country and online at kdcbroadcasting.com. It's time to get your flu shot. Plan now to visit Falston Pharmacy in Falston and get your flu shots. Only $29.99, or they will bill your Medicare or Blue Cross Blue Shield. Come on in for all the details. Again, only $29.99 for your flu shot. Don't miss work because of the flu. Falston Pharmacy in Falston has a flu shot for you. They'll even come to your business, church, or school. Falston Pharmacy, located on Highway 18 North in Falston. Use their convenient drive-through window. But get your flu shots today at the Falston Pharmacy. Set up your appointment by calling 704-538-3021. Get your flu shots today. It's time to get ready for Christmas, and it all starts at Allane Motorsports in Lincoln. Come see the Kymco Mongoose 90S starting at $2,400 or the Kymco MXU 150, $3,099. Allane Motorsports has the Kymco MXU 450i Camo now at $49.99. Buy now and save $1,400 and save $1,700 on the Kymco MXU 500i Camo. Hurry, supply is limited. Financing's available. And ask about their winch specials at Allane Motorsports, Highway 27 east of Lincoln and Iron Station.
It's big time revelry at the Renaissance Festival. Open Saturdays and Sundays, now through November 22nd.
You laugh so hard, you'll wet yourself.
The Caravan Renaissance Festival, a medieval amusement park, 12 stages, comedy, daredevil antics,
jousting nights.
Come frolic in the woods.
Incredible value, wondrous entertainment, and delicious food.
New Queen's Kitchen Pub, the Edgewood Theater, and stage entertainments.
I love the giant turkey leg.
Huzzah! Great escape. You will love it.
The Renaissance Festival is back. Saturdays and Sundays now through November 22nd. Discount tickets at Harris Teeter stores or print yours online at RenFestInfo.com. Presented by Pepsi.
Huzzah! Huzzah!
The 2015 Renaissance Festival, October 4th through November 22nd.
David, Terry, Jason, and Evan on the board this morning. Glad to have you with us. Beautiful outside. It'll be up for around 6. Cooler weekend. Cooler weekend,
I think. It's going to be nice to be outside.
Yeah, sure. I think 50 for tomorrow and Monday maybe. So that's quite a bit cooler than what we've been.
More yard work.
Get after it, Terry. If you run out, I got some.
I'm going to tell you
by.
What. Last week when I left here, I was outside cutting hedging, and it's high hedging, trying to even it off. What a nice evening. It was nice, though. It was nice.
It was very nice. It was very nice. Plenty to talk about this morning. We're going to go through some of the sports for sure. But I just want to walk through the games here a little bit last night. After Jason and Terry give the scores, it's good to go through and just – because a lot of times when you give the scores, they don't all register with everybody. And they don't all register with me when you guys give them up right here, you know, because you give me one. And for the next three scores you give, I'm still thinking about that
about
one,
the first one
because how close it was or how widespread the margin was, whatever it may be, that I miss a few. But, you know, Murphy Rosman, that's two historical programs, guys, in 1A. They played a classic game last night, 1 point being the difference in that. Robbinsville knocked off Winston-Salem Prep. I don't think that hurt anybody's feelings.
No, and you have to understand here, Winston-Salem Prep, this is only the second year of having football.
I know.
You know, they started back in 2004, I think, is when they opened up. And the basketball, we learned about it real quick. Yeah. But football-wise, it's, you know, second year into the second round. And be careful because I got a feeling they're going to be pretty decent coming up.
And you know what they can get people from what I understand, the way it works, 25-mile radius anywhere around. So how bad does this hurt your Carvers? I don't know where the school is actually located, but Carvers, the Forsyth.
But then you say in Forsyth County,
Tabor,
it's open enrollment.
It is.
Also,
but this is another team now drawing them in, you know, with even at a bigger area. I mean, well, it ain't no bigger area if it's open enrollment, but it just seems like that's going to make the other teams a little bit weaker if, you know, you just take one or two good players off of four teams. Well, and they're going to have – eventually they're going to have a 40-man roster if they don't already. So you're taking 40 people off of other teams in the area.
And Robbinsville is one of these teams, a six-time state champion. Every time that they've made it there, they've won it.
How about that? How about that? Yeah. So, you know, I know who I'll pick if they get there. Thomas Jefferson, Terry mentioned them, and Community School of Davidson, both with shutout wins. East Surrey still may be the best team in the West. They're just rolling.
Yeah, I want to jump back to Community School of Davidson against Andrews. Andrews come into this game, and don't get me wrong, they finished 6-7, but they come into this game, and two people had all of their total yardage for all year.
Oh, wow.
Coming in, only 33 yards were from anybody else on their team coming into the game last night. And then we said,
probably
here,
mistakes.
Yeah, well, me and Sam sat in here yesterday, and I said, if all I have to do is worry about two guys, I think I can stop two guys.
Yeah.
I take my chances.
Yeah.
Wow, that's hard to believe. I mean, you know, it might not be hard to believe after three games, two, three, four games, but after 12,
I know.
That says a lot. Walkertown, they may be the surprise in 1AA with what they did, knocking off the number two seed last night and previously undefeated West Montgomery and beating them soundly. I mean, beating them by 28 points after being down 21-7.
Yes.
So
yeah,
that really says a lot about this team. Walkertown last week knocked off.
Was it Pine Lake Prep?
I think it was. Yeah, Pine Lake Prep, who was 10-1, and then last night beating undefeated. So where is Walkertown?
Heard of it.
Is that in the Winston area?
I want to say it's near the area.
I'm trying to remember. But
I'm not going to say.
And I don't think the town's been around. I mean, not the town's been around a long time, I'm sure. You like that, didn't you? I don't think that town's been around long. But I don't think that – I don't remember them, the school being around long. Do you? Walkertown High? Maybe they've just made it on the scene as a football power in the recent years. Mitchell over Mount Airy, no surprise there. Seed holding up. East Wilkes over Swain as well. East Wilkes still undefeated on the season, 13-0. Lincoln over Reedsville last night. If you would have watched this game with me for the first 5 minutes, you would have thought, this is going to be a shootout. And I know you were listening to some of it, Terry, and paying attention, but Lincoln scores on the second play of the game, Taurus Dameron, 62 yards. And you know, Lincoln's defense has been stout. I thought, well, this is a big plus. They get it back and score again. They're in control. Well, Reedsville drove it 80 yards. 80 yards and had the touchdown on a one-yard run by the quarterback last night, Tanner Wilson. And I said, oh, my goodness. They missed it. They went for two on the extra point, run a fake on the kick, and ran for two and didn't get in. And I thought, this game is going to be back and forth all night long. Reedsville had 80 yards on that drive. They had 129 more the rest of the night.
Wow.
So how about that? Almost half their yardage for the game came on the first drive. Lincoln made a couple adjustments, and I think it might have been attitude adjustments more than anything, and was able to shut Reedsville down the rest of the way, beat them 36-6.
And David, you asked about Walkertown in Forsyth County, so the Winston-Salem.
I thought it was in the Winston area, and there you go, another school that's starting to make the scene. And we'll take some players as well. Take some players as well. Mountain Heritage, a lot of folks I talked to thought that Mountain Heritage would win this game, even though they were on the road. They were the lower seed. If I'm not mistaken, they were up 30-14, and Thomas will score the last touchdown to cut it to 22. So Mountain Heritage was a winner. They'll be at Lincoln next week. I think they have met three times, I'm not mistaken. And the good news for Lincoln is the home team has not lost in that series yet. Mountain Heritage lost twice at Lincoln, and Lincoln's lost one time up at Mountain Heritage. Shootout of the night in the 2A bracket, guys, Mount Pleasant and Hendersonville. I didn't expect this game to be that way. I expected Mount Pleasant to win. I didn't expect them to score 52 or give up 46. I kind of thought they'd win, 35-21, something like that. But that's an awful lot of points, is it not, for a team that's got to go play Shelby next.
That's scary.
You allow 46 to Hendersonville, and now you get to play Shelby next. But I will say this, and I'm going to look it up here and just see in a minute the score from last year. But if I'm not mistaken, Mount Pleasant might have gave Shelby their closest game last year in the playoffs. I will look that up. It may be during a break or something in a minute, but I will look that up. But Mount Pleasant played them last year, I want to say in the third or fourth round, and it seemed like that was one of the closer games. I could be way off base, but that seemed like that was one of the closer games.
I do know it's a rematch from this year, so from last year, so let me see.
Terry, did you know Rashad Butler from Winston-Salem Carver last Friday night had 412 yards rushing?
I heard y'all mention that, and I hadn't even thought of that myself. And 412
yards rushing. And then we also said, Terry, that play Shelby, he'll be closer to 12 than 412. Now, I don't know how many yards he had last night, but they only had 9 points. And I know you can't score two touchdowns and get 9 points. So they held him to one touchdown last night. Now, Coach Kloniger went to that game. He and Craig Kaiser went to that game last night and watched it. And he said that Carver, even though they were outclassed, you know, with talent, that they had the speed to stay with Shelby. He said they were a very fast team, but couldn't really put a lot of points on the board and couldn't really stop Shelby either from putting their typical points on the board. It wasn't Shelby's average, but when you're averaging how many? 40-some?
Yeah.
Actually, last year on December 5th, it was 31-17 Shelby beat Mount Pleasant. So still a two-touchdown win. Still a two-touchdown win. But
that was the regional final last year.
Mm-hmm. Actually, Shelby's I'm not going to be able to tell you their closest game in the playoffs right now because I'm on Mount Pleasant's website. But 31-17 was the score, and now they got a rematch. They'll meet up once again. East Burke, you know, we talked about our area, how good it is, how well they're doing. East Burke last night shows you what the competition's like in this area.
Oh, yeah.
Go on the road, get the upset win 27-21. Over one loss, West Stokes, and the number 3 seed, and at their place. So impressive.
They had an article that come out. I don't know if any of y'all see it. It come out in Hickory Daily Record, I think, either. Might have been Thursday or Friday, but they also had it come out in the Morganton paper of about Tom Brown and everything. And he says on Fridays after Thanksgiving, Kevin Wilson always gives him a holler if they're still playing. You know, and that's one of the last.
Head coach at Indiana, by the way.
Yeah. He said that was one of the last things that was listed. Said Coach Parker was the one that put that in there. Said that he always makes that call, and he's hoping he gets to make one more. Well, you know what? He's going to get to make one more.
Mm-hmm. Actually, Shelby's closest game last year in the playoffs was a 17-7 win at Reidsville. So that was their closest game. But other than that, that was a 10-point win. Other than that, it was the 14-point win over Mount Pleasant, because in the state championship they rolled over Clinton 31-7.
So. And you were talking about earlier, Tom Brown, his record probably fares well against the Mustangs. Well, the last time he faced East Lincoln, you have to go back to Friday, October 4th, 1996.
Man, doing research in there. I like it.
Maiden won that game 58-0.
How old were you, Smoke?
I wasn't even born. just little under a year from when I was born.
No, Smoke, we said 1996.
You was
I was a sophomore in high school, man.
I was older than that.
1996.
Oh, man. Wow. Smoke wasn't even born. But
you was part of Smoke then.
So that's the last time that he faced East Lincoln.
Yeah.
And, yeah, well – we know how good Maiden was back in the heyday, and they hardly ever lost to East Lincoln. They, you know, they pretty much dominated the series when they if and when they played them, and if, you know, didn't play every year. I like Terry's headline he had me this morning, though. What can Brown do for you? And some interesting stats for Tom Brown, who is the all-time winningest coach in the state of North Carolina. Hey, you know, we mentioned last week, you know, you're talking about East Burke went to Forest Hills, beat Forest Hills. Coach Brown forced John Lowry into retirement.
That's what he retired
on Monday. So it was so bad he forced Coach Lowry into retirement down at Forest Hills. But we talked about this a little bit Thursday night, Terry. If you add Coach Brown's win and Coach John Lowry's win, how many brackets in the playoffs won't even have that many wins from their head coaches? Not just how many matchups, how many brackets, brackets won't have that many wins?
It was close to 700. Going to 6-something, but I know it's close to 700 victories.
And I say you won't have that many coaches' wins in the bracket, in some of those brackets. That's unbelievable, isn't it?
And you're going to have the same thing this coming week. I mean, Bice has been around a while. He's got like 190-some, you know, total. And then you're going to have close to 600 this coming week.
And Bice's record has been remarkable at East Lincoln.
Yeah.
Absolutely off the charts.
121, 122, and 33.
Yeah.
Something like that. Mm-hmm.
How good's it been the last 2 years?
Yeah. That's right.
The last 4 years.
Yeah. They don't know what an L is. Let's just say it like that. They've come kind of forgotten what an L means.
You're right. You're right. And that's a good mentality to have. Very good mentality to have, because – we've seen them back in the day where mentally they weren't going to beat teams like Lincoln or Maiden. And, you know, they just walked on the field and knew they weren't going to win those games. And that's totally changed down at East Lincoln. They rolled last night while we're on that 47-6. Lou Surratt didn't play.
Yeah, on the second series of the game, right. He got hurt there. Scrambling, he was running, took off up the middle. He was diving towards the 50-yard lines. He went to fall. He was planted his left arm to break his fall, and that's when he got hit. He got hit on the fall as well.
Yeah. I was going to ask you. I thought at first you were just going to tell me it was something he did on his own, but the hit came as well. Yeah. Fortunately for him, so he's carrying the ball in his left arm.
No, carrying it in his right arm, brought the break his fall with
that's
his
right.
left
okay.
arm.
Okay, that's right. He's left-handed.
Oh, by the way, the matchup between these two for Mike Bias and Tom Brown, 560 wins between the two.
And I just wonder if they've ever faced each other. I got my doubts that they have.
I don't see how
they would have, because before Coach Bias came to East Lincoln, he was at schools that Maiden probably wouldn't have played
Athens
in the playoffs.
Athens Drive in Robbinsville.
Yep. Yeah. Yep, a 1A and a 4A. So I can't imagine Coach Brown would have ever played against them. So. Yeah, their first meeting.
Yeah, when I had Jason on yesterday, we was talking about and we mentioned Wilkes Central coming in, averaging 36.8. Mm-hmm. Look what the defense does. Yeah. Six.
Yeah. SOS. You know what SOS means? Strength of schedule.
Yeah. Well, it all depends on how you think.
It can mean many things, right?
East Lincoln defense there. Shout out to – we gave co-defensive player awards last night to T.J. McClain and Dalton Solana. They were both calling their names constantly. T.J. McClain, back-to-back plays. They try to run an option. He's stretched it out wide. They kept his outside shoulder free, got the help, come back on the inside. And the next play, he got a safety. So, I mean, he did his job there. And he's all-time leading tackle in East Lincoln history. But East Lincoln, their defense didn't get Central didn't get past the 41-yard line until their last drive of the game. And East Lincoln didn't have the ball at all. Didn't have the ball at all in the fourth quarter because it went to a running clock. And the time they got the ball at the Central score, the time they let the clock run out.
It's unbelievable. Brett was reading some things on the way home, and this is the way East Lincoln's been. He said, they got people scoring touchdowns I've never heard of. Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Yeah, Darren Martin, they went heavy on the run game after Chaz went out. They went to some I formation. They went like a heavy package with brought a fullback in the shotgun. So it was Colton Banks who had 17 carries, about 160 yards,
157, two touchdowns,
And then you had Darren Martin score a touchdown, like a 2-yard touchdown run, and everything. And
now poor Marcus Graham was not as effective as Chaz. 6 carries, 12 yards, so a little bit different there.
But 10 of
and
15
these are
passes.
I'll go ahead and give credit where credit's due. Jack O'Brien always sends me a stat sheet, from the press box. He emails me, so these are unofficial, but these are Jack's stats, and he always does a good job. But Marcus Graham throwing the ball 9 for 13. 133 yards.
9 for 13.
Mm-hmm. Surely you gave Chaz MVP last night.
No, offense. Colton Banks got offense.
Colton Banks, he was the workhorse.
But 9 for 13. The difference is in Marcus Graham's 9 completions, he had 133 yards. Where if Chaz has 9 completions, it's going to be at least 250.
Well, and most of the passes were the bubble screens to Sage, and there was a couple of passes they threw like a deep post. One to Cameron Dollar, he made an incredible catch where he deflected it to himself, and then got past the defender. So they was basically a short passing game, a lot of swing passes and screen passes.
Nonetheless, East Lincoln continues to impress. Even without the quarterback, 47 points, and 40 of them came from the backup last night. Franklin beat West Caldwell 31-7. Go ahead and tell you right quick, East Burke travels to East Lincoln. Next up for Franklin now, they've got the tall task of heading down to Monroe. Maiden led the game last night.
They did.
They led the game. Was it 6-2?
Yeah.
Yes.
6-2 because the first score of the game came on a safety, intentional grounding in the end zone for Monroe. They went up 2-0, but then Maiden took the lead briefly. What killed Maiden was I was checking the score, and right before half, the game was fairly close, and it's like Monroe scored 3 touchdowns in 5 minutes.
It was 16-13, and then, like I said, they got 3 touchdowns in that 5-minute period.
One of them was an interception when it was a 10-point ball game, and that led to Monroe getting the ball at the 11-yard line with 2 minutes to go. And they got up 30-13. I don't know what happened with the touchdown right before the half, but I guess it was another turnover. So I guess turnovers killed Maiden's shot of possibly pulling off an upset or keeping it real close.
Big win for Monroe, though. They improved to 13-0. And as I said, they will host Franklin on Friday night. Other half of that bracket, West Roanne and West Henderson. Westro, and actually that's not that's the three, bracket. I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm going down the road here thinking it's the bracket. We'll get to the brackets in a little bit. My apologies. In 3A, Westro and beat West Henderson 41-19. And South Point, a lot of people thought Statesville might pull off the upset last night because with all the athleticism and all the athletes they can put on the field. But South Point, when you don't play South Point every year,
yes,
and you have to defend this offense that they run, and film don't do it justice, you know, for what they do. They do all the little things just right and you know, score 42. I don't know how many passes they threw last night, but my guess would be five or less. And they still put 42 points on the board, you know, against a pretty good team. It's not an easy place to play either. They're very good at home.
And, you know, that all comes back to, because I remember a few weeks ago when Virginia Tech played Georgia Tech and they was talking about the front four for Virginia Tech were all seniors, and every one of them had faced Georgia Tech for four straight years, and they knew how to defend it. You know, you've got to have that. If you're never facing that offense,
it's tough.
Yeah, you have no idea where the ball's coming from and who's got it. Even if your guys are keeping the lodging, you know, this is who I got, this is who I got. You know, it does not happen if you never face that offense.
Well, Statesville actually does face that offense because they have to go against Alexander Central, who runs a similar offense as well. North Lincoln runs a wing T, so they've seen something similar to that, just not run the way
that South Point. Yeah, not run the way South Point's going to run theirs.
Yep. Not run to perfection, and that's usually what you see out of a South Point team. We'll run down the rest of the scores, talk about some other things in the world of sports after this timeout. Thanks for tuning in.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you. We're community-minded,
just like you. Hi, I'm Calvin Hastings, and I want to invite you to join me in Big O Country for our live radio remote broadcast this Saturday, November 21st, from Renato Auto Mall in Shelby. It's a big turkey and ham giveaway. Get a free or a supermarket hammer turkey if you are one of the first 10 people who take a test drive. Get a free hammer turkey with a purchase of a new Cadillac, Buick, GMC, Kia, Honda, or any pre-owned vehicle. That's right. Get a new ride to Grandma's house and the Thanksgiving dinner, too. And play the Renato Auto Mall scavenger hunt and win a free three-day, two-night stay at the Suncrest Cabins in Hendersonville. And Big O Country will be there with free prizes, too. And enjoy a free Subway hammer turkey sandwich from Subway in Booger City and Walmart in Lincoln. So plan now to be there this Saturday for the ham and turkey giveaway at Renato Auto Mall, 4423 East Dixon Boulevard, Highway 74 Bypass East in Shelby, right below the Cleveland Mall.
The Great Outdoors in Cherryville presents their three-day pre-Thanksgiving sale, November 23rd through 25th. During this special event, save up to 50%, 50% off all Great Outdoor apparel, and 40% off all other apparel, 50% off all Irish Setter footwear, and 40% off all other footwear. Offer good on in-stock items only. Plan now to be there, November 23rd through 25th. The three-day pre-Thanksgiving sale at the Great Outdoors, Highway 150 East in Cherryville, right behind McDonald's.
Before you plan your vacation, plan a visit to Country Camping Corner on Oak Grove Road between Shelby and Kings Mountain. Whether you're heading to the beach or to the mountains, Country Camping Corner has the right recreational vehicle for you. Campers, pop-ups, fifth wheels, all you need for your next vacation experience. Country Camping Corner at the Oak Grove Road Highway 74 bypass intersection between Shelby and Kings Mountain. Open Tuesday through Friday, 8:30 to 5:30. Saturdays, 8:30 to 4. That's Country Camping Corner, Oak Grove Road, Kings Mountain. 0% financing and zero money down. Now available on the 2015 Nissan Sentra and the 2015 Nissan Altima S at Marburger Nissan in Shelby. 0% financing for up to 72 months. See Marburger Nissan in Shelby for all the details. And now in stock, the new 2016 Nissan Maxima. Finance it at 2.29% APR for 60 months. Only from Marburger Nissan, 1308 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Online at MarburgerNissan.com.
Cakes and cookies, toys and gifts. Christmas at your fingertips. New ideas to get you on your way to a happy holiday.
Remember the wonder of Christmas? Smiling faces and warm embraces, delicious treats and favorite carols, tiny dollhouses and model trains, and perfect gifts under a festive tree. For 48 years, the Southern Christmas Show has brought these memories to life, along with regional crafts, wineries, entertainment, and over 400 holiday merchants. No wonder it's the largest and most popular holiday show in the country. And it's the last weekend. It's today through Sunday at the Park Expo and Conference Center. Details at southernchristmasshow.com.
Let's go to the Southern Christmas Show.
Sponsored by the Charlotte Observer. Discount tickets at Harris Teeter.
That'd be a scramble. Last night, I'm sure he was very disappointed. Had to sit out the majority of that game last night. But the Mustangs still win. Still win with the services for backup. Graham, what's Graham's first name?
Marcus Graham.
Marcus.
Marcus, only a freshman.
Quarterback and only a freshman, so I don't think they're going to be hurting too bad at that position.
Let's get on Smoke again. Now, what kind of a text you get just a minute ago?
Yeah, Smoke said they wasn't even born yet last time Tom Brown faced East Lincoln. Lewis Carpenter says, I'd only been teaching 30 years at that point in 96. So, impressive. Impressive there, Lewis. And I'm sure Lewis has probably seen a couple of Tom Brown games himself throughout the history. Battle of 12 and 13 last night. High Brighton beats St. Stephen's. I felt this game could go either way. Gave High Brighton a little edge, and they win the game. Here's one thing that history shows, that if teams meet twice in a season, regular season and playoffs, I bet you 90% or better of the time, the same team wins both meetings. Yeah. Now, teams worry about that, and rightly so,
right?
Because you're going to have to face teams, especially if it was a close game the first time, that, you know, oh, no, we got to play them again. We barely won the first time. Well, you won because you're a better team 9 times out of 10, and you're going to get to play them at your place most of the time, unless somehow they wind up seated higher than you. But most time, if you beat them, you're going to be seated higher than them when you do have the rematch. And the rematches we see this year, I only remember this one and the Patton and Freedom game, where Freedom swept Patton this year in two games. Now, there's probably more on here, and I just don't remember that they already met.
Eastern side, yeah.
But actually, Mallard Creek-Butler last night was a rematch. Did Mallard Creek win both of those meets?
Yes. So there you go. 35-30 last night.
Yep. So there you go. I mean, it's just usually if you win the first time, you win the second one as well, mainly because you're a better team.
And we had a lot more in our area last year with, in the first round, Newton Conover, Lincolnton, East Gaston, Forestview, and then Lincolnton.
Well, that Big South used to play each other twice every year. Yeah. They always played each other a second time.
They could not stand when the playoffs come.
Felt like it was in the Big South Conference tournament.
Yeah. Yep. Some big news this week, too. The realignment numbers came out, and if you're a Gaston County person, you will be you got four teams that are just trading places with each other. Hunter, Huss, and Kramer are going up to 3A and dropping down to 2A, South Point and High Brighton. So that'll make the football playoffs a little more interesting when you see South Point in the 2A large. You know, think about throwing them in there right now in that 2A large for Monroe and East Lincoln.
East Gaston State in the 3A?
East Gaston is 2A.
And
also,
South Point drop.
Good news for Lincoln County. It looks like all four Lincoln County teams are going to be back one conference. 2A. Yeah, yep. So that's great to see for Lincoln County.
And status quo for Cleveland. None of them changed classifications. They'll stay exactly where they are. So, and Catawba County had a little bit of a change up, you know, with Hickory actually wound up being still 3A. They're the smallest 3A team in the state come next realignment. But Fred T. Ford will be the team that drops down to 2A. So now Catawba County is going to have five 2A teams up there, and only Hickory and St. Stephen's on the 3A side. And then in Caldwell, West Caldwell and High Brighton are just trading places. High Brighton dropping back to 2A where they were years ago, and West Caldwell going up to 3A in the next realignment. So just a little preview there of what's to come, and that don't take effect till 2017. And the state will have out the final draft drawings for conferences sometime in December. So that's not far away either to find out what the conferences are going to look like in the next alignment, which could get interesting as well. About I didn't go far mentioning the Battle of 12 and 13, but High Brighton did win the second and swept St. Stephen's on the season.
Yeah, and when I look at that game, I start going back and I think of games that we've had earlier. You know, High Brighton and East Burke played early in the year in game one, 33-32. Yeah, and both of them teams are still alive.
Yeah, right. Nice run for both of those teams, and unexpected. Unexpected to be in the third round, and here they are. Did St. Stephen's ever lead in that game last night? They did, didn't they? Did they lead early? Did they lead first? I can't remember. Didn't mean to put you on the spot, but I was just wondering if it went back and forth at all. But it seemed like, at least in the second half, it seemed like every score I saw, High Brighton was ahead. So, Kings Mountain on the road at Freedom. They get the win last night, 21-6. Freedom, unfortunately for Freedom, they went 11-2 and lost twice to Cleveland County Schools, once to Shelby and once to Kings Mountain. And there's a lot of teams around that know what that's like. So a big win last night for Kings Mountain, a very underrated team, I thought, going into the playoffs. If you notice my little article on my website, one of my things I said was Kings Mountain could make some noise in the 3A, and they're making a lot of noise.
You know,
a lot of noise, knocking off a one seed.
You know, people's talking about B.J. Emmons being a great running back and everything. Well, Kings Mountain's got a nice 1-2 punch with McClooney and McLean at running back, and they got Darren Burns, a nice little quarterback, and Jake Merchant, one of the best athletes.
And they have a great defensive front line.
Oh, yes, most
definitely. Very athletic and big defensive front line for
Kings Mountain. Very underrated defense. Considering they're in the
impressed with that win.
Does it say how many yards that Emmons ended up with?
That's what I'm – yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to see maybe what he was limited to last night in that game. Maybe you could.
I know his touchdown came on a pass. I think it was a screen pass that his touchdown came on.
Well, one thing is you wouldn't expect his yardage to be too high. Alabama-bound running back B.J. Emmons, 28 yards on the ground.
28 yards on the ground.
28.
Wow.
28.
Well, and they've also held other running backs to very few yardage as well. I remember they held Trey Harbison to like 20 yards as well. I mean, I know Crest dominated that game, but Kings Mountain did a nice job of stopping the run in that game. They forced Crest to pass, and that's why Willie Green led Crest to victory, because he was having a hot night that night they played.
I know it's hard to say that 21-7 is total domination, but Kings Mountain, just by reading a little bit of this, totally dominated this game. I mean, Freedom's only touchdown came in the fourth quarter. They were down 21-0, and it came early in the fourth quarter, their only touchdown of the night. Kings Mountain just totally dominated this thing. And if you hold Emmons to 28 yards rushing.
This is a guy who averages 13.1 yards a carry.
That's two carries.
Yeah, a carry. And this is a guy who's got 6,800 and some yards, over 100 touchdowns, and you held him to 28 yards.
In the words of Kevin Durant, Kings Mountain defense, you are the real MVP.
Yeah.
I have to agree with you on that. That was a big night. Big night last night for the Kings Mountain defense and the entire Kings Mountain team. And congratulations to those guys as they head into the third round, where they will face High Brighton. Weddington last night. This one was a little bit of a surprise to me. I know Weddington's always good, but AC Reynolds just been scoring so many points, and they didn't score. They didn't have but 7 points in the fourth quarter, did they?
Yeah, something like that. But Weddington's never lost to an Asheville County school.
Yeah,
how about that?
They're 2-0 against AC Reynolds and 3-0 against Asheville.
Last year they went to Asheville and won. You know, so and I seen when I was leaving work yesterday and getting ready to head over to Denver on 485. It was I seen the Weddington fan car, Weddington flags flying on there. I was like, oh, they're about to make the trip to Asheville. So,
I'm gonna step out there and tell the people, Crest, beware of this team. Yeah, this is not going to be easy.
Well, didn't Weddington win the state championship last year?
They lost the state championship in a heartbreaker against one of the Guilfords.
They did lose. Okay. Real close game. They did lose last year.
And then, I mean, you know, Crest, it's hard for them being in 3AA because he had to go against a real good Cuthbertson team last night, and they have a quarterback who's going to be who's committed to Oklahoma. So now they got to go against Weddington, who's a real good team as well. Week after week, it's only going to get harder and harder.
Both teams beat Cuthbertson by 10. So if that's all you got to compare them to, it looks pretty even, right? Both teams, I think Cuthbertson lost to Weddington 27-17, maybe, something like that. Either way, it was a 10-point loss. Cuthbertson lost, and then last night 31-21 to Crest. in that game. But, yeah, Crest is going to have to beat Union County 2 weeks in a row. Mm-hmm. Get them both at home, which is a plus. But going to have to beat Union County again this coming week as Weddington comes to town. They always make noise in the playoffs. They upset South Point when you're in the first round. I mean, they've just done some things in the playoffs and just continue to get better each and every year. We've talked about this before on this show. Union County's come a long way in football in the last 10 years.
Most definitely.
Monroe is terrific each and every year. Weddington is good. Cuthbertson's good. Porter Ridge off and on is good. There's just some good football being played right now in Union County. And it's, you know, it's, I think for the last 10 years, it's been the fastest growing county in the state of North Carolina. And it was one of the tops in the nation there for a while.
Wasn't it the Weddington lost to Northern Guilford?
Roscoe? That's who it was. Yeah. They had it like on the 5-yard line, fourth and goal, and it incomplete pass. They fell short. So it was a barn burner in that game last year at at NC State. So Carter Finley. I was thinking that was Carolina Stadium. I don't know why. But
not quite.
It's all the same smoke.
Yeah. I just know Wake Forest is BB&T Field. That's the bank. And Wallace Wade is Duke.
Weddington Crest, I'm looking forward to keeping up with that game. That's if I have all the games next week, I won't move to Saturday night. That's my pick next week.
Yes.
That's my pick. I'd like to see Crest and Weddington move to Saturday so I could go see it. South Iredale, by the slimmest of margins, squeaks by J.M. Robinson
missed
last night, 14-13. How about that? That was a very, very close game. That was Rick's upset of the week. He thought Robinson would upset South Iredale, and they nearly did. But South Iredale does eke out the win. They'll now play Concord, right? They will play Concord. Concord wins over Ledford 37-0.
That should be a pretty good game, too.
Yeah.
That's a local.
Yep.
That's
maybe, I tell you right now, that's a stout Final Four in that bracket.
Yeah. Almost.
Yes, it is.
That's a very stout Final Four in that bracket when you look at Crest, Weddington, South Iredale, and Concord. How many losses between them all? South Iredale has 2, Concord 1, that's 3. And Weddington, too. So 5 losses between 4 teams this late in the season after basically 52 games. So 47-5. Yeah. That's a stout.
Well, it should be like that for every bracket for the most part, you know, with these Final Four teams in the Western Division from 1A to 4A, for 4AA.
Yeah. Is that a conference rematch between Robinson and Concord? Because aren't they, Robinson and
it would have to be. I don't know if it's conference, but it would have to be a rematch. Yeah. It would have to be a rematch because, I mean, Robinson is in Concord.
Yeah.
You know, it's the newest school in Concord. So I'm sure that they have taken some of the players away from that team. So, yeah, well, I'll check it out in a minute and see if I can find how their first meeting went back.
South Iredale playing Concord.
Oh, they did.
That's right. Jason, you had me confused.
Sorry.
Thank you, Terry.
I'm sorry.
We won't see a rematch.
I had to look at my list again. I thought maybe I wrote that down.
My bad. It was talking about Rick was picking them for the upset.
Right. They narrowly got it. Yeah. Tripper Chris on sends me a message, says Kings Mountain did dominate that game. Sends me a picture of the article in the Shelby Star today. And these stats are very shocking, he says, if you read the article and read some of the stats. And I guess the most impressive one, like we said, was holding Emmons to 28 yards last night. That's impressive.
Yeah.
That's impressive no matter how you get it done. So let's say this one more time, though. Concord will host South Iredale next week in that game. My lock last night, I was sweating. We had to pick a lock on Thursday. My lock was Catholic to beat 71st. I didn't have much choices because I was last to pick this week. And once the team's picked, we throw them out. You can't pick them again. But Catholic held on. They beat 71st last night, 20-13.
Had a long ride home.
A long ride home. Sure did.
Yeah, just a nice little 2.5-hour drive.
Not near as bad as last week, though, when they were at T.C. Robeson.
Yeah.
So only about half the trip. North Davidson upset Scotland County 46-42. Scotland County's defense left a little bit iffy all year long and catches up with them here in the second round of the playoffs. They allowed 36 in the first round but were able to win 46 last night and couldn't outscore North Davidson.
So 82 points given up in the playoffs.
North Davidson 11-1. They're actually one of those teams that's beat 4AA West Forsyth, which we'll talk about in a minute because they got a huge matchup next week too. Here's a surprise to me. Sal Caldwell knocking off A.L. Brown last night and holding A.L. Brown to 14 points beating them 23-14. And everybody always wonders, South Caldwell, a good team all year, but they slip against Freedom, get beat pretty bad, and then the next week they have the hangover, lose to St. Stephens. They've rebounded well, and everybody always says, not sure they can handle the speed of a High Point Central. They blew them out. Not sure they can handle the speed of A.L. Brown. They win by 9 points. I mean, this team's playing really good right now.
Third time in school history that they'll be going to the third round in the playoffs.
Yeah, and but then first, if you look who their opponent is in that third round, oh, boy, it's Dudley.
Piece of cake.
For Dudley. Yeah. One of them schools that ended the 4AA winning streak by Mecklenburg County down there. Yeah. So they have won a state championship.
Yep, yep, you're right, though, Smoke. They move on to play Dudley. Dudley, a 42-0 winner last night over Southwest Guilford. But now I will say this, Southwest Guilford came into the game at 6-6, so it's not like we expected much of a challenge out of those guys, at least at that point. But you got to do what you got to do, and if you're Dudley, you'll take it. You roll 42-0, and now we'll host South Caldwell. I'm going to go to the bottom one there first. Huff rolled over Audrey Kell last night. Huff 34-7, and now another rematch as Huff will play Mallard Creek. Mallard Creek had a rematch last night with Butler. They win for the second time 35-30. And if I'm not mistaken, Huff knocked off Mallard Creek in overtime early in the year. Am I right?
That's what I'm about to check.
Look that one up too. But
yeah, they did knock them off in overtime.
Huff and Mallard Creek will play again.
Revenge.
This week. Yeah, it could be. It could be. But now there again, 90-some% of the time, the same team wins twice.
Yeah, you know, and it's really getting me because when we come into this year, everybody had Mallard Creek top of the line, shouldn't have never got beat, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Got all these Division One prospects on their team, but they've had some tough games this year.
They have.
Yeah. Some people have played them, you know, to the last possession.
Charlotte's a lot more balanced than it's been the last several years because it was either Mallard Creek, Butler, Independence, all the way back to West Charlotte. You know, those teams seem to dominate, and it seems more balanced. And you know what? This could be the year that the West champion don't come out of Mecklenburg.
Yep. Yeah.
Those Forsyth teams are strong, East and West, and they play each other next week, and somebody's got to beat them in that fourth round.
Yeah, out of the last 15 years, 12 of them have come out of Mecklenburg County.
Yeah.
The only three that have not, Greensboro, Dudley won it once, New Bern won it once, and somebody else in here won it once.
You're saying the state champ.
State champions, yeah. You know. But amazing because, I mean, Mecklenburg County has pretty much dominated the 4AA.
Yes, they have. Yes, they have. And, you're talking about the 3AA being stacked, and it is with those four teams. The 4AA is pretty stacked, too, with West Forsyth, East Forsyth, who both won last night, and East Forsyth beat Independence 49-7.
That was never close.
Wow. Yeah, it don't look like it.
No.
And now they'll play West Forsyth, which is a rematch. Mallard Creek will play Huff, which is a rematch. And I don't care who you get in that Western final out of those four, it's going to be a good one.
Yeah.
It's going to be a good one. We'll find out if the 90% rule holds up next week, if the teams that win the first time win the second time, because East Forsyth's already beat West one time, 28-24, and it was close, and Huff's already beat Mallard Creek, and that one was in overtime.
Yeah, 31-28.
In overtime. So how about that? I mean, those are two really good rematches on paper between pretty much four powerhouse schools in North Carolina. So, yeah, we'll have to pay attention to that as well and see how the night goes for all those schools. So if you guys could move one to next Saturday night, what would it be? I've already picked Cuthbert.
I want to see Huff Mallard Creek put it at Memorial Stadium.
It would be very good, wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. It'd be very good.
Surprised Tom Warner might not try to make that a TV game.
Hey, you know, why not? I'm a little worried about that. Looking at South Caldwell, and I just want to check them real quick. We're talking about what they've done, you know, after losing those games back-to-back earlier in the season, their only losses back-to-back to Freedom and St. Stephens. But since then, they've put up 70, 48, 35, and 23 against a good A.L. Brown team last night. So now they got to travel. First time out of Sawmills as they travel to Greensboro to take on Dudley. It'll get a little bit tougher.
Doesn't South Point play West Rowland, if I'm not mistaken?
Yes.
Yeah, I think that one would be a nice one to watch, too.
Two teams that have been really strong in the last 10 years. So, very good. We'll take a timeout. Back with more sports talk in a moment.
Care about the future of this community. You grew up here. You've raised a family here. Your life is here. So is ours. Carolina Trust Bank. Member FDIC.
Community minded, just like you.
Hi, I'm Calvin Hastings, and I want to invite you to join me in Big O Country for our live radio remote broadcast this Saturday, November 21st from Renato Auto Mall in Shelby. It's their Big Turkey and Ham Giveaway. Get a free or a supermarket hammer turkey if you are one of the first 10 people who take a test drive. Get a free hammer turkey with a purchase of a new Cadillac, Buick, GMC, Kia, Honda, or any pre-owned vehicle. That's right. Get a new ride to Grandma's house and the Thanksgiving dinner, too. And play the Renato Auto Mall scavenger hunt and win a free three-day, two-night stay at the Suncrest Cabins in Hendersonville. And Big O Country will be there with free prizes, too. And enjoy a free Subway hammer turkey sandwich from Subway in Booger City and Walmart in Lincoln. So plan now to be there this Saturday for the Ham and Turkey Giveaway at Renato Auto Mall, 4423 East Dixon Boulevard, Highway 74 Bypass East in Shelby, right below the Cleveland Mall.
Mike Rowe here with Dave, an electrician with Mr. Sparky. Today, Dave is conducting an electrical safety inspection. Dave, how many of these have you done?
Thousands.
And have you ever found a home without any electrical problems?
Not yet.
Let me translate. If you live in a home and rely on electricity, call Mr. Sparky before something goes...
That's not what electricity sounds like, Mike.
No, but this is what a jingle sounds like.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Dave, is that you singing? Each independent franchise is licensed in its respective state or county.
Having trouble finding a car or truck at a price you can afford? Your troubles are over when you stop in at Bill Holland Automotive in Lincoln. At Bill Holland Automotive in Lincoln, they make buying a pre-owned vehicle easy. No credit, no money to put down? Bill Holland Automotive has the banks to get you approved. Come and see the selection today at Mill Holland Automotive, 423 West Main Street in Lincoln, or visit the website at millhollandautomotive.com for a complete list of inventory. Give them a call at 704-736-1000. Today's high school football game has been brought to you in part by the Royster Memorial Golf Course at the Shelby City Park on West Sumter Street in Shelby. Playing at the Royster Memorial Golf Course is like playing at the mountains without the drive. Ask about the kids' junior programs and the new membership packages. For your tee time, call 704-484-6823 for the most affordable rates in Western North Carolina, or visit them online at cityofshelby.com. Good luck, teams, from the Royster Memorial Golf Course in Shelby. Charlotte Hornet basketball right here at Big O Country. WHS Shelby, WCSL Cherryville, WLON Lincoln, online at kdcbroadcasting.com. It's the year-end closeout sale at Hojo Power Sports and Equipment in Shelby. Prices have been slashed. All units must be sold. And now get 0% financing for 54 months, plus up to $400 in rebates on selected models. Now's the time to buy with name brands like Snapper, Bobcat, Walker, Ferris, and more. But hurry for the best selection, the year-end closeout sale at Hojo Power Sports and Equipment, 110 Gregg Street in Shelby. Open 8 to 5 Monday through Friday, 8 till noon on Saturday.
Jason, Terry, Smoke, having a good time this morning. Been talking high school football, which is obviously dominating this time of year. But hats off to North Lincoln girls basketball last night. First win in three seasons.
Yeah, very hard working for those girls. They've had to go through a lot of growing pains. I mean, they've gotten better and better each year, so I'm just glad to see that they finally got a win.
High school basketball is right around the corner, that's for sure, and we'll see a lot of good matchups. And
West Lincoln kicked off and started this season early this week.
They played North last night.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, Well, we'll get into it in just a minute. I think we're gonna get a phone call before we go too much further. But and we want to give the scores again, obviously, to those late risers. But I was gonna mention a couple basketball things. Maybe I shouldn't because I'm not 100% sure on them. But I think I'd heard that Ashbrook lost a couple basketball games to some local teams.
They did lose. I did remember seeing them have a loss earlier this week.
Well, we're gonna go to the telephone lines now. Coach Gibson, is that right, Smoke? Coach Gibson on the line with us. Coach Lebford Gibson. Late night getting home last night, Coach, but you're up off early this morning and probably got a smile on your face.
Yeah, pretty happy this morning. We played pretty well. We needed that one, and it's good to go get a win against a really good team and a really good program. I think that's good for our guys.
Yeah, 18 state championships, and they've got a flag high, a big flag for each one of them behind their home stand. It can be kind of intimidating, but 18 state champions and most in the state of North Carolina. But you guys have been playing well. I mention this pretty much every week. You go out and you consistently play good. And I don't remember some of the really, really the state championship teams for LinkedIn playing as good and as consistent for this long a period of time. But the first question I want to start with, Coach, last night you drive right down the four, your stud back, Taurus Dameron, 62 yards on the second play of the game for a touchdown. But then Reidsville drove it right back down, 80 yards, score to pull within 7-6. And then what happened? What did you guys do that limited them to only 129 yards the rest of the night?
Well, came out that first series and got after pretty good. I don't think our guys were prepared. I've been telling them all along all week that, you know, this was a good football team and, you know, they better get ready to play. And I think they were a little bit caught up in the moment and didn't realize how good a team they were against. And then when they got out there, they kind of got hit in the mouth, and then when they got the sidelines, I got after them a little bit, and they realized how good they were. In the next series, they kind of stepped it up a little bit and started playing a little harder, and we made a couple small adjustments on how we were lining up, and we seemed to play a little better from then on. We still gave up some plays here and there, but overall, they just stepped it up and played a little better.
I'm going to start on the defensive side, and, of course, another good effort by you guys last night. Defended the pass well. If I'm not mistaken, we heard this last night. I think and this is going to be a rough estimate, but I want to say the quarterback last night, Fort Reidsville, was something like 12 for 22, something like that, maybe 12 for 25. But his longest completion of the night, I think, was only 11 yards. So you guys did a good job of containing it, keeping the game short, and making tackles 90% of the time last night on the first contact after they caught the ball.
Yeah, our DBs did. After that first series, we gave up a couple pass plays on two fourth down plays on that first drive, just like all the defense that first drive, like I said, wasn't quite in the game. But after that, they started playing a little bit tighter, and they did tackle well when the receivers caught the ball. They were on them pretty quickly, so they played pretty good after that first drive.
And you just mentioned the secondary, and on the other side up front, you guys defensively, your defensive line, your linebackers seemed like on the first couple drives had a hard time with Reidsville's offensive line trying to get pressure on Tanner Wilson, the Reidsville quarterback. But as the game progressed, it seems like you got more and more pressure, forced him out of the pocket, and he didn't throw near as well when he was on the run.
Yeah, I think I believe they were we missed Baker. Nathan Baker didn't get to play. We tried to let him play a little bit, but his mm-hmm. knee was just too sore, and
that was he couldn't play.
And I think they missed that a little bit because he's a little quicker mm-hmm. up front and. Took the guys a little bit of adjusting. Took me a little bit as a coach of changing a couple things and putting in a little couple different stunts to get a little more pressure on the quarterback that way. And once we adjusted to that, I think it helped us a little bit.
With Baker being one of your better defensive players, and you got a pretty good squad on defense all the way around, so I won't sit here and say he's the best. I'll leave that up to coaches to determine who's the best. But he has really been a real good player for you guys on defense this year. Is the knee improving?
It's improving slowly, not as quick as we thought it was, not as quick as he thought it was. He wasn't where he thought he was last night. He wanted to try to play, so we gave him a couple plays to see where it was. And then once he got out there, he couldn't put the weight on. He couldn't move like he wanted to, so we kept him out after that. And hopefully we can get some rehab on it this week and give him a chance this week to play and see how he goes.
Very physical game last night, Coach, on both sides of the ball. I thought Reedsville was one of the more physical teams you guys have played all year. But that doesn't seem to affect Taurus Dameron. He just seems to thrive on that kind of stuff, and he seems like he don't mind the contact at all, and he hardly ever goes down on first down. The Reedsville guys in the press box says, hey, this is the best back we've seen all year. This kid is dynamite. He just keeps churning for yards. Last night, 197 yards against a good Reedsville defense, three touchdowns. He's consistent.
Yeah, he is. He's a bull. He runs through stuff, and then when he breaks out in open, people don't realize how fast he is.
Right.
Once he gets out there, there's not many going to catch him once he's out in the open field, and sometimes he can make his own little spot. If you give him a little bit, he's going to run over a few in the defensive backfield. They don't want to come up and make any contact with him if he's got a little bit of a run at him. He's definitely made a big difference there once he gets going.
Yeah, another big night for him last night. And Coach, a lot of times the unsung heroes don't get mentioned, but I talked to you at the beginning of the year, back in August before the season ever started, and everything seemed to be okay with you, except you said, we need to find some linemen, we need some offensive linemen. And it seems to me like, Coach, these guys have done a pretty good job now through 13 weeks. They seem to have really done a good job of improving each and every week.
Yeah, those guys have really come together. About the fifth or sixth game, they started gelling. We started having about five or six of them they're using in there. Actually, seven, I think, that they rotate in. And those guys have really come together and done a real good job. They picked up things real good, and they've opened up some holes. And we're getting the Taurus and the Big Yard. We're also getting Xavier McLean and some of the other backs. When they come in and get Taurus a break, they're getting some holes and gets some pretty good yards too, so the offensive line is doing a really good job.
Coach, not too shabby first-year coach. You're going to be practicing on Thanksgiving. Most coaches will consider it a very successful year if you make it to the third round that Thanksgiving weekend where you get to practice on Turkey Day and then play on Friday night. Not only are you doing that, but you're even going to be playing at home.
Yeah, that's great. But with our fans, it doesn't matter because we get a great following either way, mm-hmm. But it's great to be playing at home. I know we had a bunch of fans there last night, and I want to thank them for that. But getting a home game, that's great for our players, and I think it's going to be that's a big thing for us. So hopefully that'll give us a little bit of an advantage because that Mountain Heritage team coming in, from what I hear, I haven't got a chance to look at it much yet, just a little bit, but they look like they're a pretty good football team.
No, you answered my question. I didn't get to ask it. I was going to say, what do you know about Mountain Heritage and you know, who was a winner last night on the road at Thomasville? So obviously a good team or they wouldn't be playing in the third round.
Yeah, they're a typical Mountain Heritage team. They're not quite as big as they were when we played them before, but they still got some pretty good sized linemen. They're good up front. Their quarterback's really good. I think he's over 2,000 yards rushing, and he throws the ball well too. But they also got another back that's over 1,000 yards rushing also. So they still run that power run game out of the shotgun and run the quarterback a lot out of it, and just come downhill at you. They just keep coming and try to power it at you and say stop us.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's going to be a tough matchup for us.
I'm looking forward to it, Coach. First, congratulations on that win last night, getting to the third round with the win over Reedsville, 36-6, and definitely want to wish you the best in the upcoming third round hosting Mountain Heritage. Thank you for your time.
I appreciate you guys. You have a good one.
Thank you. Coach Ledford Gibson there. One of those guys, we have some coaches like that around in this area. Mike Bias is another. Can't tell in their voice if they won or lost. You know, I mean, he's just pretty even keel. Have to ask him if he was excited. Have to ask him if he was smiling and if he was happy because you can't tell it in the voice. He stays pretty even keel, and that's probably a good thing for a coach. You know, never too excited over the wins, never too depressed over the losses. But he's done a tremendous job with this team in his first year. You know, I mean, he's done a really good job with this team in his first year as head coach, and they will move into the third round next week. While we're on coaches, I do want to mention something, and then we're going to give all the scores from last night for the late risers. But Terry laid this over here in front of me. Coach Tom Brown, his East Burke squad, with the big upset win last night at West Stokes. 363rd win of his career with 130 losses, seven ties in 41 seasons. Won the Western North Carolina state title in 71. Won the whole state, the state title. When it was started being combined, he won one back in 1978 with a win over Mount Tabor, Tabor City, which is now South Columbus, so went over Tabor City back in the day in 1978. He's a member of the Lenoir-Rhyne Athletics and Catawba County Sports and North Carolina Athletic Directors Association Hall of Fame, also the NCHSAA Hall of Fame. So if you got it in North Carolina high school, he's a part of it. 2005 State Coach of the Year, most wins at one school in state history when he left Maiden. Two-time Shrine, and that was in 07, by the way. Two-time Shrine Bowl coach, coached the Unifor's first two AP All-State Players of the Year, or State Players of the Year. His Maiden teams from 90 to 2006 won 10 or more games 14 times in 17 seasons, which also impressive. 41 teams, 32 have made the playoffs, and 36 have reached six wins or more. So why are we surprised when he goes and pulls off an upset of a three seed?
You are correct. And one more question before we go to break. Who is the lowest seeded team still available that's in our brackets? Take a guess.
It's got to be High Brighton.
High Brighton's a 12.
Yeah.
It's amazing. I couldn't believe it neither when I pulled it up. Northern Guilford. Number 13. Seed. Still playing.
And that shouldn't surprise us
no,
at all.
No, it should
either.
Not. I mean,
that shouldn't
you know.
Surprise us at all either because they always seem to make a deep run into the playoffs, and here they are again. Scores from last night, high school scores from last night. We'll take you through all the West scores right now.
All right, in the 1A West, it's Murphy defeated Rosman 28-27. Robbinsville defeats Winston-Salem Prep 37-15. Thomas Jefferson with the 24-0 shutout over Union Academy, and Community School of Davidson with the 24-0 shutout over Andrews. In the 1AA, it's East Montgomery falling to East Surrey 56-35, and Walkertown with the upset over West Montgomery 63-35.
Continuing with the 1AA, it was Mitchell over Mount Airy 41-14, East Wilkes over Swain County 22-7. In the 2A bracket, it was Lincoln in 36, Reidsville 6. It was Mount Heritage 30, Thomasville 22, Mount Pleasant 52, Hendersonville 46, and it was Shelby 34, Winston-Salem Carver 9.
In the 2AA, it's East Burke with the win over West Oaks 27-21. East Lincoln continues their winning streak as they defeated Wilkes Central 47-6. Franklin knocks off West Caldwell 31-7, and Monroe continues their winning streak as they defeated Maiden 58-20. In the 3A, it is West Rowan with the 41-19 win over number 3 seed West Henderson, and number 2 South Point knocks off Stakes for its 42-21.
Continuing with the 3A, it was High Brighton 28, St. Stephen's 23. Kings Mountain with a dominating performance on defensive side, 21-6 over Freedom. In the 3AA, it was Weddington 28, A.C. Reynolds 21, Crest 31, Cupperson 21, South Iredale 14, J.M. Roberson 13, and Concord 37, Ledford 0.
In the 4A, it's 71st High School traveling over to Charlotte Catholic. Catholic was with the win 20-13. North Davidson with the upset win over Scotland County 46-42. South Caldwell with the 23-14 win over A.L. Brown. And Greensboro Dudley shuts out Southwest Guilford 42-0. In the 4AA, Mallet Creek defeating Butler 35-30. And Huff knocking off Archer Kale 34-7.
Continuing with the 4AA, West Forsyth 20, Myers Park 3, and East Forsyth, no trouble with Independence, 49-7.
And you were mentioning Dudley in that win last night, their second straight shutout, 54-0 over McDowell last week to open the playoffs, 42-0 last night over Southwest Guilford in round two. Dudley has given up 82 points this season, which is amazing. Their highest they've allowed a team to get on them is 14, and that happened twice, 13 one time, and then it was either 7-6 or 0 that they've allowed. So South Caldwell will have a tall task at hand next week as when they travel to Dudley. This team has beat some good teams. They lost a game. They lost to Richmond County 14-12, but guess what? Richmond County's still playing in the 4AA.
Yes,
so that's not too shabby of a loss. So this team is really, really good, playing their best football right now, and they will be hard to handle at home, but definitely want to wish South Caldwell the best of luck as they travel to take on Dudley next week. And speaking of some of the matchups next week, Denny Hoover, who I talk to real regularly, has Ken people at Mountain Heritage. And I don't know if either one of them have too much confidence in their team next week because they've got a bet already for Thanksgiving leftovers. How weak is that? How weak is that? Now, it tells me they don't have a lot of confidence in their team to come out and get those wins. Do they?
Well, it's a win-win.
I mean, you know.
Can't beat it, right?
Unless somebody can't cook.
Uh, you know, maybe I'm underrating the bet here. Maybe it's a lot better bet than I think. Maybe I should be in on it and get to sample both sets of leftovers. Thank you for tuning in this morning to Sports Talk. We'll take a quick timeout, run down today's college football schedule when we come back.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you.
We're community-minded, just like you.
Hi, I'm Calvin Hastings, and I want to invite you to join me in Big O Country for our live radio remote broadcast this Saturday, November 21st, from Renato Auto Mall in Shelby. It's their big turkey and ham giveaway. Get a free or a supermarket hammer turkey if you are one of the first 10 people who take a test drive. Get a free hammer turkey with a purchase of a new Cadillac, Buick, GMC, Kia, Honda, or any pre-owned vehicle. That's right, get a new ride to Grandma's house and the Thanksgiving dinner too. And play the Renato Auto Mall scavenger hunt and win a free 3-day, 2-night stay at the Suncrest Cabins in Hendersonville. And Big O Country will be there with free prizes too, and enjoy a free Subway ham or turkey sandwich from Subway in Booger City and Walmart in Lincoln. So plan now to be there this Saturday for the ham and turkey giveaway at Renato Auto Mall, 4423 East Dixon Boulevard, Highway 74 Bypass East in Shelby, right below the Cleveland Mall.
Who shall separate us now?
Clemson, here we come!
No one.
As they take the 2014 Russell Athletic Bowl.
Our Tigers are ready to streak to the top of the ACC and beyond. Clemson football lives here on the Clemson Tigers Sports Network.
Clemson Tiger football right here on Big O Country. WHS Shelby, WCSL Cherryville Gastonia, WLON Lincoln.
Mike Rowe here for Mr. Sparky. You know, the first time I heard this jingle, I thought to myself, well, isn't that a catchy little tune? Then, after 300 or 400 times, I began to wonder if I'd ever get it out of my head. I don't mind. The message is kind of important. If you need an electrician you can trust, there's only one place to call. But don't take my word for it.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
You were singing along, I know it. Each independent franchise is licensed in its respective state or county.
Get the cutting edge. Get the commercial grade with Kubota's new Z700 Series Commercial Zero Turn Mower. That raises the bar for quality, durability, precision, and all-around value from Parker Farm Service in Kings Mountain. No other mower in its class even comes close. Cut with the best. Cut with a Kubota Z700 with a comprehensive 2-year warranty. See Parker Farm Service, 126 Bessie Drive in Kings Mountain. Ask for the new Kubota Z700. Charlotte Hornet basketball right here at Big O Country. WHS Shelby, WCSL Cherryville, WLON Lincoln. Online at kdcbroadcasting.com.
Welcome back to Sports Talk. David, Jason, Terry, Evan on the board this morning. And before we get back into some sports, we're going to check in with Calvin, who's over at Renato Auto Mall this morning. What's going on out there, Calvin?
Hey there, David. Yeah, we are at Renato Auto Mall in Shelby, getting ready for a big day. Hey, it's going to be a fun day here. We've got the sunshine, and we've got the giveaways coming up. Again, the first 10 people who take a test drive today get a free hammer turkey from Aura Supermarket and Broad River Hams. That's Swervin' Irvin up there on East Marion Street in Shelby. He's the man to see. Go by and see him and take your certificate in. But first, come on by, take a test drive. Check out one of these big old GMC trucks. They've got some beautiful Cadillacs here. Got the Buicks and, of course, got the Kia and got the Hondas here at Renato Auto Mall. And we're going to be here broadcasting live till 2 o'clock today. Mr. Perkins is on the way. He is the sub man today. We're having free Subway sandwiches from Subway in Booger City. And, Terry. But anyway, we're going to have... We're going to have a Subway sandwiches here. There we go. And register to win. We got some great prizes today. Free rounds of golf of a Pine Mountain. $25 gift card to the Parkway House in Cherryville. $25 gift card to Newt's. A Marshall Tucker Band CD. They played over in Charlotte last night. And some What's Up Shopper T-shirts. We've got some of those we're going to give away too. Now, if you happen to buy a new vehicle today, you get a free hammer turkey as well. So you get you a new ride to Grandma's house, and you get the Thanksgiving meal too. Also, we're still raising money for our friend Sandy Alexander. We've got a few Sandy Alexander CDs. These are gospel CDs, and of course Sandy is a great pianist, and we've got some of her CDs here. They're $10, and all the proceeds will go to Sandy to help her with her medical expenses. Or if you just want to make a donation, we've got a big old jar here, and we'd like to see you fill it up here today at Renato Auto Mall. All going for a good cause. Sandy's pretty good. All right, check out the deals today. Paul's going to come out and talk with us here in a little bit. And also, the Kia Thon returns to Renato Kia. Get the best deals of the year. Save up to $7,000 on the 2016 Kia Sorento or purchase a 2015 Forte Coupe for just $239 per month. That's right, not a lease. A new 2000 Forte Coupe for just $239 a month. That's just one of the deals here today at Renato Auto Mall here in Shelby. Again, we're located on Highway 74 East, 4423 East Dixon Boulevard, just below the Cleveland Mall. Come see us. David, we'll send it back to you.
All right, Calvin, appreciate it, buddy. We'll check in a little bit later with him as well over at Renato Auto Mall in Shelby. Get out there and check it out. Free turkey for those test drives. That's a pretty good deal. That's a pretty good deal. Shelby Golden Lions last night, a winner over Winston-Salem Carver at home, 34-9 last night. And Coach Lance Ware, the head coach for the Golden Lions, kind enough to join us now on the phone. How are you this morning, Coach?
Good morning. Doing well.
I hear the excitement in your voice there. You guys are going to the third round again. Last night, convincing win at home over a pretty good Carver team. But I guess the story of the night, and I'll let you give us an update. Everybody's questions were on Darquez Lee.
He's going to be fine. It really he kind of got kicked the second. I think it was the third play of the game, kind of in that same leg that had been bothering him. Went over and kind of kept it moving. Chuck Sims came in, led us to open touchdown the first drive. And Darquez came back in, made some things happen in the passing game when we needed to. And then we pretty much leaned on our running game. Xavier Brooks had a big night, over 100 yards, and try to keep guys off of Darquez and just survive in advance, really, against a very athletic Carver team.
Yeah, that kid you call Truck, he came in and led you to your opening drive. You go up 7-0 on the Jaden Borders 26-yard pass, actually 6-0. Extra point was missed. Carver got back in it with a field goal, but as you said, Lee comes back in and he leads your offense just like you would expect him to do. But, Coach, you guys just seem to be playing well on each side of the ball. And as I've said about some of the other teams in our area, that their defense gets better each and every week. It seems like yours does exact same.
It does. Very proud of our defense. And this time of year, you got to play great defense. And, they gave up 9 points, but they held them to a field goal. And after we were kicking it short, we were not going to kick it deep to their outstanding return man. And then the other one, we threw a pick and gave him the ball, right there at the 20-yard line. So overall, we had a great, great night on defense. Offensively, we converted 3 fourth and 10 plus for touchdowns. I thought that was
unreal.
Kind of strange. Yeah, but it was Truck's first pass, and then two to there to Jaden. But we had a big night from Antoine. We also missed one right there before the half. So crazy game though. A lot of swings. You never really got to feel comfortable against a team like Carver. Let me ask you this. Unnecessary things, too.
You were on the good side last night of those fourth down conversions. How deflating can that be for an opposing team whenever you got a team fourth down and more than 10 three times and it's turnips touchdowns? How deflating can that be for Carver?
Well, it's awful. It's just a punch in the gut right there, and it takes the wind out of yourself. That's so frustrating as a defense that, you know, you get them where you think you got them, and then they just. I'd like being on this end of it. That time, I can tell you.
I guarantee it. You feel like, you know, we've stopped a team for three downs. And then we can't stop them on fourth down. They're converting these fourth downs and tens not only into first downs but into touchdowns, and that really does have to take its toll on our defense. Another big night last night for some of your players, and one that always stands out to me is your star wide receiver, Jaden Borders.
They took their quarterback and put him on him man-to-man there early, and he really seems like the bigger of the game, and he just – makes plays. He's great with his hands, great after the catch, and I think Dark West has a lot of trust in him to put the ball up there and he'll go get it.
You know, Coach, I'm gonna go back a little bit. I'm gonna talk a little bit about some of the other teams. We've gone through some schedules this year, and we're looking at some playoff teams that have gone deep. And it seemed like there for a while we were saying we would name a team. They were a one seed. Only loss was to Shelby. We'd name another team. They were a two seed in the playoffs. Only loss was to Shelby. And I'm referring to teams like Freedom. I'm referring to teams like AC Reynolds. South Point's only loss was to you and Crest. And now there's a third member. Cleveland County's really having a good run because Kings Mountain now has stepped up and beat Freedom last night. You guys, to me, have played probably – you and Mallard Creek, I would say, and Vance High and Charlotte have played probably the strongest schedules in the state of North Carolina this year. And I know that you're a Shelby guy, and that's where you should be, but you got – I think right now the county should be just boasting about all three of those teams and how well the whole county is doing in the playoffs.
Oh, we are. I talked to Coach Lloyd last night and yesterday congratulated him, and he does the same for us. You know, it is big. I talked to him, and he was asking me, you know, about Freedom. I had no doubt they'd go up there and play well, and they could win. He's got a good football team, Kings mm-hmm. Mountain. They play an excellent defense. They don't make a lot of mistakes offensively, and, you know, he's got the formula to how he's playing defense to be successful and move on. You know, hey, good friends of Coach Laws, I hate how they lost the heartbreaker up there, and, you know, great kid there, Rico Dowdle, but that's kind of in the playoffs, you're going to have those kind of things happen. You got a lot of good teams, but there are a lot of good teams that we've played, won and lost, still playing. So you're good to see South Point doing well, and, you know, Coach Gibson and Lincoln, I know some people think that we're going to meet down the road, and we'll worry about that then, but what he's done this year in his first year, that's not easy. That's not easy, and he has had a great year. He's got his kids playing well.
Yeah, we've just got some good football. We're fortunate right here at our local stations here and in our area. We have really got some good football teams, and I think we have the best football in the state right here in this little 30-mile radius from our Cherville station. It just seems to be doing so well each and every year. You get another familiar face next week, Coach. Last night you beat Carver, a team you beat last year, I think, in the second round as well. And now you play Mount Pleasant, a team you faced last year in the playoffs.
Right. You know, looking around at for us having a one seed, they didn't do us any favors with who we've got matched up. Mount Pleasant, they'll be very well coached, and we know they're going to line up run right at us. Coach Johns, great guy. Always has his team prepared. You know, they'll have the revenge factor, all that stuff. But we've got to take care of ourselves. We've got to take care of the ball, clean some things up, get some guys healthy again. We had a few banged up last night. But nothing beats that Thursday night, 8 o'clock, and turn the lights on, us practicing on Thanksgiving.
That's pretty incredible.
We don't take that for granted. We don't take it for granted. We'll go Wednesday morning, give them as long as we can, you know, away from us and with their families, and then bring them back 8 o'clock Thursday. So then on this football. So exciting time of the year. Glad to be a part of it.
And, Coach, we're definitely glad you are a part of it. Congratulations on the win last night, and definitely want to wish you good luck next week when Mount Pleasant comes to town.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Coach Lance Ware there. Now, you can hear some cheer in his voice, and rightfully so. I mean, his team has just been incredible all year long. Only loss coming to Crest, a big rivalry game, which they played them to a 7-point game. And this team has beat some good football teams. Yes. I mean, some good football teams. It's unreal what they've done.
I'm going to go over how our conferences are doing. The Southern Piedmont 1A are 4-3 in the playoffs. Community School of Davis. I mean, yeah, Davison still, and Thomas Jefferson still available. The Southern District 7 is 6-3 with East Lincoln and Lincoln still available. The South Mountain 8-2 in the playoffs, you know, and they still got four teams available. Chris Shelby, Kings Mountain, and East something. Burke.
The two, one's East Rutherford, who played Reedsville pretty good in that game. So East Rutherford's one of the teams that's out, and they had to go to Reedsville, which is a hard place to play, and they played them pretty good. The game wasn't really decided until the fourth quarter. And who's the other?
RS Central.
RS Central. Now, they
lost
were shut out. I was a little surprised.
Well, lost
but
to
it's
Franklin.
A good team, but a very good team. So, yeah, these teams make good showings because of who they have to play during the season.
They do. You know? In the Big South, they are 2-4. The only wins are by South Point in that conference. And the Northern Piedmont is 3-3. Mm-hmm. Still has South Iredale available. And the Northwest 3A, 4A is 6-4. In the playoffs.
That's a surprise there. That's probably the surprise out of all of our conferences right there, and the fact that High Brighton's still going. Yep. How about that? So, hey, it's really good time of year. It's interesting football. There's plenty to talk about. Here's what I'd like to lay out there, and we're going to go to break, going to take our final break before we come back and look at the college football schedule. But here's a question I'll lay out to you guys. Is there a better chance right now? Eagles, hold back a minute. I didn't say 1, 2, 3. Is there a better chance that we see at least two teams from Cleveland County in the state finals, or is there a better chance that we don't? Think about that for a minute. We'll take a break. Back in 1 moment.
Against your skin so bright.
Right over here with it.
Easy there.
Great.
Rates are low today. The time is right to improve your home. We have home improvement loans and we're lending right now. Join your neighbors and friends and people all over our local communities who are improving the quality of their lives by improving the quality of their homes. We're an equal housing lender. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community minded just like you.
Cookies, toys, and gifts. Christmas at your fingertips. New ideas to get you on your way to a happy holiday.
Remember the wonder of Christmas? Smiling faces and warm embraces, delicious treats and favorite carols, tiny dollhouses and model trains, and perfect gifts under a festive tree. For 48 years, the Southern Christmas Show has brought these memories to life, along with regional crafts, wineries, entertainment, and over 400 holiday merchants. No wonder it's the largest and most popular holiday show in the country. And it's the last weekend. It's today through Sunday at the Park Expo and Conference Center. Details at southernchristmasshow.com.
Let's go to the Southern Christmas Show.
Sponsored by the Charlotte Observer. Discount tickets at Harris Teeter.
Buy here, pay here at the Essener Auto Sales in Shelby, the home of the satisfied customer. Come in now for your next vehicle at a price and payment you can afford. See their selection online at EssenerAutoSales.com and pick up this week's WhatsApp shopper and play the Essener Auto Sale Sports Trivia Game. Win a free $10 gift certificate to the clock. Essener Auto Sales, 417 South Post Road in Shelby, right next to Bojangles, the home of the satisfied customer. Be sure to pick up this week's WhatsApp shopper for some great Black Friday specials. You'll find special deals from Pro Wellness Chiropractic on North Aspen Street in Lincoln, Sandy's Country Christmas on West Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, St. Ace Hardware, Highway 27 west of Lincoln, at Victoria Cole Gifts and Collectibles in downtown Cherryville, from Honda Motorcycles on East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, from Carolina Furniture Mart on North Aspen Street in Lincoln, from Hometown Hardware on South Railroad Avenue in Kings Mountain, from Lewis Feed and Tack on Highway 321 South in Gastonia, and from Designer Deals Outlet on East Marion Street in Shelby. Be sure to pick up this week's What's Up Shopper and save money. It's time to get your flu shot. Plan now to visit Falston Pharmacy in Falston and get your flu shots. Only $29.99, or they will bill your Medicare or Blue Cross Blue Shield. Come on in for all the details. Again, only $29.99 for your flu shot. Don't miss work because of the flu. Falston Pharmacy in Falston has a flu shot for you. They'll even come to your business, church, or school. Falston Pharmacy, located on Highway 18 North in Falston. Use their convenient drive-through window. But get your flu shots today at the Falston Pharmacy. Set up your appointment by calling 704-538-3021. Get your flu shots today.
Is the cost of ink driving your profits down? Then listen up. Discount Inkjet and Toner is here to help. And now they have a new additional location in Shelby at 1725 East Dixon Boulevard, just below Crossroads Ford. Discount Inkjet and Toner specializes in refilling inkjet and toner cartridges. Cut your ink cost by as much as 50% or more. Discount Inkjet and Toner, 410 East Franklin Boulevard, Gastonia, and now open in Shelby at 1725 East Dixon Boulevard in the former Little Moo location. 100% satisfaction guaranteed.
And welcome back to Sports Talk. A little Baton Rouge there. Some of the folks calling for Les Miles' job after dropping two in a row. We shall see how that pans out toward the end of the year. Before we get back into sports, and we are going to talk about sports for the final 10 minutes this morning with college football, but we're going to check in with Calvin again over at Renato Auto Mall in Shelby. What's going on, Calvin?
Okay, thank you there. Hey, we are at Renato Auto Mall, and we're on Highway 74 East in Shelby. Invite you to come on over today, believe it or not. Hey, well, I tell you what, that's a good deal. You take a test drive, you get a free or a supermarket Broad River ham, turkey or ham today. And a matter of fact, a gentleman came up and said, I want to test drive one of those Kia Souls. And if I do, say I get a free ham or turkey, I said, you got it. So he's done loaded up and he is gone. So he's taking a test drive right now. So come on out and do the same. First 10 people take a test drive, get a free ham or turkey. And I tell you what, all day long today, if you purchase a car today, car, truck, brand new, used, pre-owned, whatever, you get a free ham or turkey from Broad River Hams or a supermarket in Broad River Hams today. Hey, check it out. That's a steak place. Register today. We got free rounds of golf at Pine Mountain, $25 gift card to the Parkway House in Cherryville, $25 gift card to Newt's, the Marshall Tucker Band CD, and some What's Up Shopper D shirts. And check out the deals here. Mr. Perk called. He is on the way. He is almost here with a Subway sandwiches from Subway in Boger City. Great place to get you a sub sandwich. Drop by and see the fine folks over there. We appreciate everything they do. And while you're here today, be sure to make a donation for Sandy Alexander. We've got some of her gospel CDs here. They're $10. All the proceeds will go to help with her medical expenses here. So you can make a donation. If you don't want to buy a CD, just make a donation. That'd be a great thing to do today here at Renato Auto Mall. All right, we're going to send it back to you. Oh, Terry. Back to you guys.
All right. Thank you, Calvin. We will check in again throughout the day with Calvin. Butch Parker just sent me a message. Just a thought on this late November Saturday. Several Maiden guys still in action this year. Alex White and Ryan Crawford in the game at Harvard today. Kevin Wilson, former Maiden player, former North Carolina Tar Heel, head coach at Indiana, now playing Maryland today. They gave Michigan all they wanted last week.
Oh, God, they should have beat them, Coach.
Had their opportunities last week. And Coach Parker and several folks from Maiden were at that game last week and nearly pulled off the big upset over Jim Harbaugh's Wolverines. Keith Henry, still coaching at Catawba. Biscuit Ramser is at Hampton. High school level, Justin Holm is at Shelby, helping coach at Shelby. And some former coaches, Josh Robinson is at East Lincoln, Greg Pound, Buddha Hensley there at Langton. And, of course, the old man, Tommy Brown, not too shabby. Hope I didn't forget anybody. And there you go, Tom Brown getting it done at East Burke once again. I did want to mention some of the college games today real quick. A big one at 12 noon right off the bat, North Carolina playing at Virginia Tech. Is this Beamer's final home game period?
And they're going old school with the helmets, the VT on one side, the number on the other side. So It's going to be – they're going to be playing with heavy hearts. And I don't – I think this is just a crazy rumor, but if this does truly happen, it would be amazing. People were speculating on Metallica might be there at the stadium to play Inner Sandman.
That'd be awesome, wouldn't it?
Oh, my gosh, that would be
awesome.
Now
you're going to make me watch.
Yeah.
I'm watching that game just to see.
I'm watching that game just to see that, too.
And I hope it comes true. Hope it comes true. Jason, you're a Carolina fan. Chances North Carolina wins this game?
I'm going to say 70-30 right now.
The Terry, Carolina, you're not a North Carolina fan.
I'm about the same way. It could be 80-20 on mine.
No, I'm just the emotion, though, at Beamer's last home game. That's what I'm worried about.
You just got to get through the first quarter. Carolina survives the first quarter because Virginia Tech's going to give them all they got right off the bat.
And that offense for Carolina is extremely hard to stop. I mean,
play them well.
They're explosive, man.
Yeah, right. They'll survive until next week when they lose to State.
Do what?
Say that again. Terry. There you go.
We got him. So he says NC State is going to beat North Carolina next week. He's already counting down the days, aren't you?
And Dallas going to beat Carolina.
Oh, Lord.
It's going to be a great week coming up.
What you woke up and drank this morning?
It's like someone's been drinking that Kool-Aid there.
Terry's special sauce or something. I don't know. What are you drinking?
Georgia Tech is at Miami. Michigan is at Penn State. I know a lot of folks in this area are not really Big Ten fans, but this Big Ten race is really shaping up to be something down the stretch because Michigan has to hope Ohio State wins today over Michigan State. So Michigan will have a chance next week
to beat them
to win that division and then play Iowa, who's undefeated on the other side, in a championship. Right. I mean, this thing's a mess.
Iowa's got a cakewalk. They don't even have to play Penn State, Michigan, Ohio State, or Michigan State. And you also got to remember today's game, it's going to help Michigan's chances. I think I heard Connor Cook's a little beat up, and Michigan State's been struggling these past few weeks.
I've seen the spread. It's like Michigan State – I mean, it's Ohio State's favorite to win by 13. I still can't see that, beat Michigan State by 13.
Yeah,
Michigan State usually plays well when they're an underdog in a big game.
Yes,
I mean, that's when they usually step up.
And this is the first time this year that Ohio State's playing a ranked team. They're one of only two teams that have not played a ranked team, and that's – Ohio State and North Carolina being the only two teams.
Well, this is people said now Ohio State's season officially starts today, that the preseason's over with. Now they're with Michigan State, Michigan, and possibly Iowa in their next three matchups.
Oregon's at home to take on Southern Cal. That's a battle of ranked squads.
Yeah, SC still alive for the Southern Division of the Pac-12.
So how bad is the Pac-12?
It's not. I mean, Utah's got two losses. Everybody's beat me.
Face it, Jason. I'm gonna find a Jason.
No, everybody's beating up on each other. That's what's happening there. You know, it's not like the out-of-conference losses are bad. It's just that everybody's
– Do they have a chance at all to have anybody in the Final Four?
It takes mayhem. Not anything right now.
Well, you know, USC, they need to start doing this every year where they fire their coach midseason because they start winning after that.
Yeah, chill.
Two times now.
Utah is a pretty good team, ranked 13th. They play at home against UCLA today. I think I already mentioned Northwestern and Wisconsin, a battle of ranked teams. Of course, the top one of the day, Michigan State, Ohio State. That's number 9 at number 3 today at 3:30. Alabama, man, they play Charleston Southern. That's Barkley Raider Bayou down there in Charleston. That's Lincoln. He's the head basketball coach down there.
Yeah.
He might want to shut his eyes today and not see too much of that Charleston Southern.
Well, according to Saban, it's going to be a close game.
Yeah.
You better not take this game lightly.
Till the kickoff.
I mean, you remember last year, Western Carolina gave Alabama a little bit of a fit. It was a back-and-forth ball game for a quarter and a half, and Western also did a good job for about a quarter and a half against Texas A&M last week. It was only a 7-point game at halftime.
Hey, I give Western some credit. They've got off to good starts in these games. Oklahoma State's at home to take on Baylor. That's tonight at 7:30. That's a big one, guys. Number 10 and number 6. Can Oklahoma State stay unbeaten?
And
TCU at Oklahoma.
Already said no Trevon Boykin tonight.
That's a big blow. Yeah. That's a big blow to that TCU offense.
And they struggled against Kansas without him.
Notre Dame is playing what they've called, I think, a home game in Boston today at Fenway against Boston College. Somebody had to explain that to me, how that's a home game for Notre Dame. But that should be pretty amazing. I'd love to see. I will watch some of that just to see what football looks like in Fenway. You know, they've hosted hockey recently, right. Some of that outdoor hockey like a lot of the stadiums have done. Number one, Clemson at home to take on Wake Forest. You guys still satisfied with Clemson being the number one team overall?
Yes.
Yeah.
I agree. Yeah. I agree. I think they've earned it. I think they've done a good job earning it. Hey, they got key wins, one over Notre Dame and over Florida State. So that's two pretty good wins, and they've, you know, you can only beat who you're dealt, and they've done a good job of doing that.
I think the game between Clemson and Wake Forest might be a little bit low scoring than people expect because
smoke.
Well, I mean, you look at what Wake Forest did against Notre Dame. I mean, it was only like 28-7. I think people are thinking it's going to be like 41-7, something like that. That defense for Wake Forest,
they did play well.
Bad.
They did play well in that game.
So, I mean, I can see them.
Clemson's just so explosive, though. Yeah, you know,
I like
Clemson struggled with Syracuse last week. So
every game Smoke has, the other team has an opportunity. Then they start playing the game. Good job,
smoke.
He's even doing it to himself, isn't he? Auburn plays at home against Idaho. Not a bad schedule today for this late in the year. Tennessee, Missouri, Texas A&M, Vanderbilt. As I mentioned earlier off the air, Charlotte is going to Kentucky. UNC Charlotte playing Kentucky tonight on the road at 7:30. And Cal at Stanford tonight, 10:30 game. And Washington State, who's continued to play well, I think, under Mike Leach. And Mike Leach, the mad scientist, still the coach there. Yep. He's doing a real good job up there with those guys at Washington State. I say he'll have him contention for a Pac-10 title in a couple of years.
You left off the game of the day, though, in Greensboro. Aggie Eagle Class at 1 o'clock today at Greensboro. North Carolina A&T versus North Carolina Central. Winner will go to the MEAC championship game.
How about that?
Yeah.
How about that?
And don't forget, State plays Syracuse today.
And State also, we got LSU and Ole Miss. That's probably the biggest game in the SEC today.
LSU, I just wonder if they will make a coaching change if things don't turn around drastically. They only lost two in a row to good teams. But
Les Miles can't beat Alabama lately.
No, and they definitely got more talent than Arkansas and couldn't win that game the very next week. You know, remind me of the Sal Caldwell earlier in the year when they lost to Freedom and then they lose to St. Stephen's. LSU kind of did the same thing last week.
And in the NBA, Golden State Warriors just moved their winning streak 14-0. They're now one win away from tying the record for most opening season for undefeated for a team. They got a chance to break the record Tuesday night against the Lakers if they did.
And that was against that's the Celtics that have that record, the 58-59 Celtics, I believe, are close.
When it's all said and done years from now, will Steph Curry be in the top five all-time NBA players?
Yes, if he keeps playing like he is now, yes. Maybe. Yes.
It's hard to believe.
Yes.
But you know what?
No.
I mean.
And he's gotten better.
He's headed that direction right now. He's headed that direction. It's unbelievable what he's getting done. And the rules favor him now more with less contact and things like that, you know. And I've heard now he's increased his shooting range to 10 feet behind the arc.
Yeah.
10 feet behind.
I believe that. Just watch
him
play.
Unbelievable what he's doing. Thanks for tuning in to Sports Talk. We can say it. Coaches don't think it. Are we headed for Lincoln Shelby Showdown? And are we headed for East Lincoln Monroe Showdown? And
also,
final.
Also with South Point Kings Mountain.
Kings Mountain.
South
that's
Point,
right.
Kings Mountain. Unbelievable what we could have. Unbelievable what we got. And unbelievable what we could have in the regional finals. Thanks for tuning in. See you next week on Sports Talk.